Today we're looking at George Washington Carver. Hello, welcome to the Daily Bellringer. Please don't forget to subscribe and take a look at the questions down in the description. Also, don't forget to check out dailybellringer.com where you'll find more resources that go with many of the Bellringer videos. George Washington Carver was an agricultural scientist and inventor who revolutionized the way crops were grown in the United States. Carver was arguably the most famous African American scientist of the 20th century. Carver was born in either January or June of 1864. Records are unclear as to his exact birth date, as he was actually born into slavery. At the time of Carver's birth, slavery had not yet been abolished in America. He was born in Diamond, Missouri, in southwest Missouri. His owner was Moses Carver, and before George was born, his father Giles died. Then, when George was barely a week old, he, one of his sisters, and his mother Mary were kidnapped by Arkansas raiders that roamed through southern Missouri during the Civil War. They were taken to Kentucky and sold. Moses Carver, however, hired someone to track them down, and they did find George, and he was brought back to live with the Carver family. After slavery was abolished, Moses Carver and his wife Susan adopted George and raised him as one of their own children. George learned to read and write, although attending school was not easy, as most schools in the area still only allowed white children to attend. So George had to attend several different schools in southwest Missouri and eastern Kansas, trying to find somewhere that would accept him. George was a very frail and sickly child, but at a young age, George gained a very strong interest in agriculture, spending most of his free time in the family's garden tending the plants. After graduating from high school, Carver wanted to pursue a higher education in college, but again faced discrimination as it was difficult for him to find a college that would accept him because of the color of his skin. Eventually, in 1890, he was accepted at Simpson College in Indianola, Iowa, where he studied art and piano. There, one of his professors encouraged him to go and study botany or plant science at Iowa State University. In 1891, he became the first African American enrolled at Iowa State. In 1894, Carver graduated with a Bachelor of Science degree, making him the first African American in America to earn that degree. His professors thought he was so brilliant that they urged him to stay and earn his Master of Agriculture degree, which he did in 1896. Soon after, Carver met Booker T. Washington, who was a leading African-American intellectual and principal of Tuskegee Normal Industrial Institute in Tuskegee, Alabama. Washington hired Carver to establish an agricultural science department at Tuskegee, and Carver accepted and would teach there for the next 47 years. By the way, George was so impressed with Booker T. Washington that he added Washington as part of his own name. During these years in the early 1900s, Carver conducted research and especially focused on soil depletion, or in other words, when soil loses its nutrients to grow plants, usually because of overplanting. In this case, across the South, years of planting cotton had depleted the soil. Carver developed innovations in crop rotations, or alternating what crops were grown, in order to replenish the soil. Carver's research and innovations aided in helping the South's agriculture to bounce back after years of overplanting. But Carver's most famous work was with peanuts, discovering hundreds of more uses for them, such as cooking oils, soap, medicines, wood stains, and even milk. But I must note, Carver is sometimes mistakenly assumed to be the inventor of peanut butter. Peanut butter was actually invented by Marcellus Gilmore Edson in 1884. Through his research and discoveries with peanuts, Carver became somewhat of a celebrity. Carver traveled throughout the United States giving speeches, demonstrating how farmers could grow more and better crops. He was an advisor to both President Theodore Roosevelt and Franklin Roosevelt, and even testified before Congress on agricultural issues. He became a close friend of Henry Ford, as together they worked to try to find a soybean-based alternative to gasoline for automobiles. Thomas Edison even attempted to get Carver to leave the Tuskegee Institute to come and work at Edison's famous Menlo Research Laboratory. Carver even traveled to India and met with Mahatma Gandhi and discussed the nutritional value of soybeans. In early 1943, Carver fell down a flight of stairs at his home in Tuskegee. He was found unconscious by a maid who then rushed him to the hospital, but unfortunately, he died on January 5th of 1943 at the age of 79. George Washington Carver overcame racial injustice and discrimination to become one of the greatest scientists of the 1900s. Through his work and research in agricultural science, he revolutionized how crops were grown and helped to feed millions of people. So with that, hopefully you learned something, and thanks for watching.